do, what's happening? It's your boy Marc Henry back on the third Coast Gridiron on the LSC Network. Powered and sponsored each week by our title sponsor, Fat Cow Beef Jerky. Real food, no bull. Let's go. It's week four, man. We're starting to get into district play. We'll talk about last week's games, the big win by the Northshore Mustangs in the Mustang Bowl against Westfield. And we're going to talk to one of the young and up-and-coming quarterbacks from St. Thomas High School, Donte Lewis. We'll talk about their hot 3-0 start and get to know him a little bit. Let's go. Week four, man. Telling you, it's getting down to the nitty-gritty. In the H, we're going to see who's going to start to show up and who are the teams to beat coming up in week four. We'll talk about that in a few big performances here in H-Town. We'll take a break, and we will come back and talk week three football in the H-Town. This is Marc Henry on the LSG Network on the Third Coast Gridiron. We'll be right back. Marc Henry here, man. We appreciate you listening to the Third Coast Gridiron, man. But as I move around from stadium to stadium and event to event, sometimes I get hungry and I just can't stop at Whataburger or Jack in the Box or anywhere to grab something. I reach in my bag and get some Fat Cow Beef Jerky. Real food, no bull, man. It's jerky made from 100% beef. Fat Cow Beef Jerky is a small business with a big heart and love for high quality, man. We're talking about the ultimate flavored meat snacks, man, with a taste of real American ingenuity, man. I love Fat Cow Beef Jerky. And this year, I'm proud to say that Fat Cow Beef Jerky is the title sponsor for the Third Coast Gridiron. Check out Fat Cow Beef Jerky. Utterly perfect jerky. Thank you for listening to the Third Coast Gridiron. I am Marc Henry. We're back. Let's talk a few scores and a couple of big games from week three. Definitely the biggest game that was talked about around town, around the state, was Westfield and Northshore, and Northshore came out on top, beating number 7 Westfield 55-25. Big game by Rashaad Johnson, 144 yards on 9 carries and 3 touchdowns, as the Northshore Mustangs took care of business. Great defensive game as well. The Northshore defense is doing its thing, man. These guys are really, really dialed in, and you know, kudos to John Kay and those guys over there for putting together a great program, and this is what they do. But big shout out to my guy Rashaad Johnson, who's one of the best running backs in the state, in my opinion. You might want to check him out. He's got the nickname Baby Bo for a reason. Also, our prayers and concerns go out to David Amador, their top receiver. Had an injury that night, but he seems to be doing well from all the things we've been hearing. Just want to send a shout out to him and his family. Great that he's doing great. Now let's move to another big game. Katy versus Tompkins. This was a district matchup as well as a rivalry that's been building the last couple of years. Katy comes out on top. Late interception by Micah Sweats to win 14-13 over Tompkins. Seth Davis heavy on the ground again. 2 touchdowns and 111 yards on 25 carries. But Tompkins is not a team that you definitely can sleep on. This is a highly contested game. It's been that for the last 4 or 5 years. And again, a late interception by Katy gets them out of there with a 14-13 win to move to 3-0. Now we'll go with a few more scores here. Sharpstown over Wisdom 28-12. Columbus beats Rice Consolidated 49-0. Santa Fe over Rayburn 51-13. Clear Springs beats a tough Klein Forest team 24-17. Zayshon Edwards for Clear Springs had 2 fourth quarter touchdowns to kind of help the Chargers win over a very talented Klein Forest team who came in undefeated. I mean, these guys are very, very talented. Got one of the top players over there that's committed to University of Houston. So that's a big win for Clear Springs. Shout out to Clear Springs. Nimitz, 34-7 over Side Park. George Ranch with a big win on a late field goal by David Michael, a 17-yarder for a 24-21 win. So, that's a big, big thing. You know, never forget special teams. Sometimes we overlook the kickers. They are athletes, too. A few more scores here. Friendswood over Kempner, 27-7. Columbia over Randall, 36-35 in a highly contested game. Nequalen Grice got in the end zone on a 7-yard run late in the game, and a 2-point conversion by Kavion Lewis was the difference. As Randall came up short, that brings them to 2-1, and it's a very good team over there. Shout out to Columbia for digging it out there to get a great win. Also, Shadow Creek over Bridgeland, 38-6. Shadow Creek's 3-0. That's a big, big win for them. Bridgeland's been tough the last couple of years, and the Sharks, they'll have a bye week, and then they'll go into 23-6A play on the 23rd against Pearland. So they got a week to prepare for those guys. And shout out to Shadow Creek for getting a big victory. Ridge Point 56-0 over Bush. Bay City 58-6 over Worthing. Wall Trip, the Rams 55-7 over Milby. Sean Crawford had a big night, 50-yarder run in the third quarter for a touchdown. And Wall Trip, they'll be off this week, but they'll come back and start district against the Northside next Friday. But shout out to the Wall Trip Rams. Sam Houston, 36. Aldine, 30. Cinco Ranch, 49. And Katy Taylor, 28. And a big, big shout out to, again, the Katy Tigers for coming up. What a big, big win. I mean, we got a lot of, talk about the Westfield and Northshore game. But for Katy to continue their winning ways, that's a big deal. You know, Tompkins has been right there on their heels the last couple of years. And you just want to give a shout out to those guys. And you know that they're doing a great job over there. We'll take a small break and hear from one of our sponsors. And we'll come back and talk about a few great performances around the Houston area in week 3 here on the Third Coast Gridiron. Living in Texas, you guys know that the weather's so unpredictable, almost bipolar at times. We don't know if it's going to be rainy or sunny. It's going to be storming. We could get snow. That takes a toll on your roof. My guys over at American Shield Roofing and Construction can take care of you. They are dependable, honest, and insured. When you find yourself in need of a roofing repair or looking for a roofing company, look no further than American Shield Roofing and Construction. When dealing with a roofing company, you need a roofing contractor who is dependable, who arrives on time, and can provide you a quality new roof in a timely manner. They give you an honest quote, as accurate as can be, and they give accurate estimates. Check out American Shield Roofing and Construction. Give them a call at 361-343-7018. That is 361-343-7018. And you can also go on the website and schedule an inspection or get a quote. That is AmericanShieldRoofing.com. One more time, AmericanShieldRoofing.com. A proud sponsor of the Third Coast Gridiron.
Did you play Texas high school football? If you did, you're part of an elite group, the Brotherhood of Texas High School Football. All football players, past and present, who have ever suited up in the Lone Star State are eligible. Go to LoneStarGridiron.com/brotherhood and thank you for the part you played in the greatest sport in the greatest state.
Let's dive into some of our grind and shine moments of the week. These players stood out, had big performances around the Houston area in week 3. We'll start with Rashaad Johnson, running back senior from Northshore, 9 carries for 144 yards and a 55-25 victory over Westfield. He's a big-time running back. If you hadn't seen Rashaad play, you better get to see him. He'll be playing on Saturdays pretty soon. Nicholas Tremble, the second running back, freshman, over at Houston, Washington, at Booker T. Washington High School. Shout out to Nicholas Tremble. Had a chance to meet him on the roundup a couple of weeks ago at the in the beginning of the season. Like during practice, we went around and we talked to Washington, spent a day with them. And Tremble was a big contributor in practice, and we knew that he would come out and have a big role in offense over there. 46-26 victory against Pasadena last week, 174 yards and a touchdown on just 10 carries. He's a name that you need to know, just a freshman, so he has a few more years to hang around and make plays over there for the Washington Eagles. Shout out to Nicholas Tremble II. Ashton Ajoku, running back, Foster, man, he had a big game for the Falcons in a 41-0 victory over Terry, 287 yards and 4 touchdowns. Ashton's a big factor for Foster. They're usually very talented over there, and he's one of the guys that's been performing at a high level so far in 2022. Grayson Lynchcomb, linebacker. Let's jump on the defensive side for Memorial High School. Big game against Klein with 11 tackles, 8 solo and 2 forced fumbles help them in a 35-30 victory. Man, he's a big-time linebacker over there. Definitely the defensive guys are definitely represented. And another big-time performance from a Katy Tiger, Micah Sweats, DB, over there with the interception to seal the deal, 14-13 and a victory over Tompkins. Very, very good sound DB, very smart. He saw the keys from watching film, he says, and he took care of business to help Katy get a big victory. Nash Rankin, quarterback at Stratford, 19-26, 352 yards and 3 TDs, 56-0 victory over Hastings. Xavier Butler, running back, senior at Brazosport, had a big game, 202 yards and 4 TDs for a 34-12 victory over Vider. Maybe Matar, junior quarterback, one of the most highly recruited quarterbacks probably in the state that you'll want to see. The Woodlands got back on the winning trail as well, 22-32, 336 yards and 3 TDs, and a 45-17 victory over Oak Ridge. And they also rushed for a touchdown. So the Woodlands isn't done. They had a tough one, out of the gate with Northshore, but Northshore is tough on everybody. So for him to bounce back and have a great game, that shows that the Woodlands is still in it. And they'll be around when it comes playoff time. Justin Thomas, running back from Galveston Ball, 202 yards and a touchdown in a victory over Madison, 39-0. William Hicks. Let's jump on the defensive side. C.E. King, they bounced back. They went up to Allen a couple of weeks ago and had a tough time, but they bounced back with a victory over Pearland, 45-7. 10 tackles, 3 for loss, 2 pass breakups, and a forced fumble. Definitely Hicks was very busy on Friday night. Johnny Robinson, running back from Fur, and a 68-0 victory over Provision Academy, 192 yards and 3 TDs. Christian Womack from Tomball had a big night in a 34-21 victory over Dawson, 216 yards and 4 touchdowns. And last but not least, let's talk about the St. Thomas Eagles. They had a big victory up in the Dallas area over Fort Worth Nolan Catholic and Johan Cardenas. He's a junior running back over there. He's a load, man. He's a big-time running back that you hadn't heard about St. Thomas. We're going to talk to one of their top performers as well in Donte Lewis. Well, let's talk about his running back mate, a backfield mate, 190 yards rushing, 4 TDs on 18 carries, and also 68 yards in the air and another score. So, Johan, he's a factor over there for St. Thomas. But we'll take a small break, and we'll come back with his teammate and the engine that makes that thing go over there at St. Thomas.
Stats for last week, 295 all-purpose yards, 2 TDs passing in week 3, 19 for 33. He's already had a 300-yard total game and 3 TDs. We're talking about Donte Lewis, quarterback for St. Thomas High School. He's a guy that you need to know. Coming into his junior year, superb arm, great athlete. He can do it with his feet, but he can do it with his arm, make all the throws from any platform, does well when he rolls out. He's making some action happen over there at St. Thomas. They started out this season 3-0. We just want to bring him in and talk to him here on the Third Coast Gridiron. Come on in, Donte. How you feeling, baby?
What's up, man? I'm doing good. How you doing?
Doing great, man. Super excited for you. First of all, congratulations on the 3-0 start. I had a chance to get by. Yes, sir. I had a chance to see you guys on the Houston Roundup, made a stop, and you were looking very, very sharp then, and now it seems to come in full circle. Just talk about the fast start 3-0 that you guys have had so far.
Man, it's just been – we've been really locking in practice, and we've just been kind of – we've been trusting each other. And then just the relationships that we have, You know what I'm saying? And that kind of – people don't think that helps, but that really does, and that helps build team chemistry even when you're not on the field, you know? And so it goes, like, even helping each other with homework, making jokes, just going out to eat, stuff like that. And you just kind of build that love for each other and trust and know that you can count on your brother to come pick you up and work together to get the win. So that's kind of how that 3-0 has been going. And then, you know, just – we've been grinding, man. It started this summer when I first came to St. Thomas for the first practice, and I was just I had just started getting in the playbook. And so then we went to Waco and just lit it up out there, man. We went the first day was okay. I mean, we did okay the first day. I think we went 2-1. And then the second day we went 4-0 straight. We won the whole thing. And so that's when I knew it was home. You know what I'm saying? And I knew we could be something special, but it would take every single one of us, and it would be the little things that mattered, and we just have to focus in on things like that.
Well, you've been focusing very well. I had a chance to see you early on when you guys were going through fall practice, and to, you know, check on you week to week and see you start to flourish. That means that you've picked up the playbook. You kind of got a chemistry with your guys on the offensive side. Just speak to that a little bit.
Man, I love those guys, man. My old line is, I love those guys, man. We go to dinners and things like that just to build the love for each other. And just we, in practice, they're always picking me up. I'm picking them up. You know, it's kind of a mutual thing. And the wide receiver core is crazy, man. I would say we have the best wide receiver core in Texas. We got Larry Benton on the outside, 6'3". We got Nick Ferruzzo. We got Caleb McClure, Luke Edgecombe, Trey Robinson, Schaefer Henderson, Preston Bowman. That's his last name. Yeah, man, our wide receiver core is crazy. You know what I'm saying? So when we're all on the same page and we're all just hitting spots and focusing on our own thing and then bringing it together as a team, it will be unstoppable.
Well, it looks like the chemistry is there, and you guys are definitely one of the hottest teams in the state, definitely in the Houston area. Again, this is Donte Lewis, quarterback for St. Thomas High School. Now, let's talk about that O-line, because none of this happens with those guys. What has that been like playing behind those guys? And, you know, they've been keeping you pretty clean.
Right. Yeah, man, them dudes keep me real protected. I have a great line, man. They show love. I love those guys so much. And, you know, even in practice, even when there's a slip up, I get on them and I get on their behind, but they know it's out of love because they know I want what's best for them. And so when I get on their behind, they take it as constructive criticism, but they're like, all right, let's do better, because we know in the game when they're tired and we're not, that's all because in practice and stuff like that. But yeah, man, they keep me real clean back there. They give me enough time to make the read or the progression or hand it off, run it. You know, they get me right. So shout out to them. Love y'all, man.
Now you led into my next question. You talk about progressions. And before we started, we talked about throwing receivers open. How is that important in your game to kind of just see the field very well?
Man, that's real important because, you know, at some points you're not even going it can be a moment where you're not even going to be able to see the wide receiver, but know where he's going to be at and anticipate it. You know what I'm saying? So it's just them being there, trusting that they're going to be there, and them trusting me that I'm going to throw them open. And it's just going to be a pitch and catch sort of thing.
Well, it's been pitch and catch last week, over 300 yards in week two. Both running and passing. Talk about that a little bit. You're able to do things with your feet, but you're a passer first. You got the arm strength, and, you know, you can throw on the run very well. What are some of the keys to kind of just having that comfortable nature back there in the pocket?
Just being that, just watching film and being familiar with the playbook, man. That's the big thing. Watching film is what helps you be able to read the field and know where they're going to be, know what their defense is going to do, the safeties, the corners, the DNs, the linebackers, knowing every assignment, you know. So that's kind of how that goes. And then I just, what helps me feel comfortable, just select QB, man. I go, my guy, Daryl, Coach Daryl and Milton, they get me right, man. They show me love over there. So I just want to shout out to them, man. They just, whatever I need to work on, I bring it to them and they help me and they break it down. And they show me what I do wrong and they help me fix it. And that's kind of what helps me stay focused back there and remember the training, you know?
Absolutely. Shout out to Select QB. They've been doing a great job with you. You know, I've been following you for a couple of years now, 707, and now you're doing it on Friday nights at the highest level. And that's a great attribute to those guys and what you've been doing off the field. Now, before we get out of here, I'd be remiss if I didn't talk about baseball a little bit. If you don't know, Dante's one of the top baseball players in the Houston area as well. He gets it done on the diamond. Just talk about baseball a little bit and how that kind of helps with football. What are some of the things that you do well in baseball?
Man, baseball is crazy. I play shortstop, third base, and I pitch. And, you know, the main thing with quarterback is I'm a pitcher. So they kind of go hand in hand. You know, my pitching coach, Coach Demetrius Mitchell, that guy, man, he's something else. My first lesson with him, my mechanics was kind of me and my own trying to figure it out. But when he first got with me, he just tweaked a few things. So my numbers just started to jump, and, you know, and so that's kind of how that was. I recently got invited to Area Code this summer to play in California. And, you know, I would say I did really well out there. I went 6 for 5 or 6 for 10 at the plate. I stole like 6 bases. And I just want another shout out to Kyle Washington, my batting coach. Man, I've been with him for forever now. And that's my dog, man. I love him so much. And he gets me right. He shows me the little things, and he that's one thing he stresses a lot is the little things, man, and just how those things turn into big things, and how you can, if you do one little thing right, it can open a whole bunch of doors for you. You know what I'm saying? So that's kind of where I'm at with that. And just, yeah, baseball is just the positions I play. They're very, very similar. So that's another thing that helps me in football is because of how hard I throw. I can use that same arm strength of football to maybe fit it in the window when there may be nothing there, and just things like that, working on my legs, making a run for it on the football field, you know, things like that, being able to escape the pocket, all those things correlate. And so when I work on my legs for pitching, it kind of helps strengthen my legs for football and me getting faster and things like that. So that's kind of how that goes.
Well, definitely it's going 3-0. You guys at St. Thomas are on the way, on the verge of making some noise as you head into district play. Before we get out of here, Donte, we appreciate you joining us here on the third Coach Gridiron. But this is the part of the show where we let you kick some shout-outs. So thank some people and also give you social medias where everybody can follow you.
Okay. My Twitter handle is Donte, capital D, Donte, capital L, Lewis, 18. And my Instagram recently, my Instagram is offline right now. I don't know what's going on with it. So I can't give you my Instagram right now. It's I can't log in. So I don't know what the problem is with that, but that should be up and running hopefully pretty soon. So I'll try to get my Instagram out there for y'all, but yeah. And then also I have a YouTube. I don't know if y'all know about that, but it's called 2D Lou 2 Sports. Me and my brother started it in 2020. And so we just basically recorded us on the grind and stuff like that, and just building and getting ready for moments like this and opportunities like this. So that's kind of how that's at. And I want to give a shout out to my coaches, Coach McGuire, Coach Hudson, and everybody like that, and Coach Davis. You know, those guys really, they show me love, man, and they take care of me over there. So I just, if I haven't said it enough, I just want to say thank you for everything that y'all have done and continue to do. And mark my words, the goal is the state championship. So that's the goal for the coaches, man. I want it for them, and I want it for myself, and I want it for the team. So just got to keep pushing.
Well, keep pushing and congratulations on a hot start. And we'll be keeping up with you guys as you start district play and most likely on into the playoffs. Again, this is Donte Lewis, junior quarterback at St. Thomas High School. He's a guy you need to know. Check him out. College coaches are going to be knocking on his door real soon. We'll take a small break and hear from one of our sponsors here on the Third Coast Gridiron on the LSU Network.
Are you looking for a podcast network that talks Texas by Texans? Well, check us out. You're already listening to us, but go to the website, LoneStarPodcast.com. You can also find us on every big podcast platform, LSPN. We have shows in business, entertainment, marketing, music, of course, sports. We have some of the best sports podcasts in the state of Texas, ranging from high school football all the way up to pro basketball. So check us out online, LoneStarPodcast.com. That's the LSPN on every major podcast platform.
This show is brought to you by the book, All I Need to Know I Learned from My Texas High School Football Coach, a handbook of wisdom for parents, young people, and yes, even coaches. Head over to www.learnedfromcoach.com and order your copy to support sharing the stories of these great coaches and leaders. That's learnedfromcoach.com.
If you're looking for a home or an apartment, or looking for first-class service and selling a property, call the Location Agency. The Location Agency is a first-class real estate group with the resources to help you locate, buy, and sell property throughout Texas. The Location Agency has been serving Texas real estate clients for over 20 years and can help you with all of your real estate needs. Give them a call at 832-724-0631 and ask for JR. The Location Agency is a proud supporter of the Third Coast Gridiron and the Lone Star Gridiron Network. Go to thelocationagency.net for more information. Big shout out to my guy Donte Lewis for hopping on the Third Coast Gridiron. Let's talk about a few games before we get out of here that you might want to take a look at. 10-5A matchup, Foster's 3-0. Angleton comes in at 2-1. 5A D1, that's a big matchup. 7 p.m. at Wildcat Stadium. The Falcons are averaging over 46 points a game. So we'll see if Angleton can stop them. And that Foster train has really been rolling. Big victories over George Ranch, Travis, and Terry to come in to this contest. Let's look at 8-5A Division I. Crosby 2-1 comes in against Barbers Hill, 7 p.m. Eagle Stadium. They suffered a big loss at the beginning of the CE King, but Crosby's rebounded. Barbers Hill's won two straight, including a 59-7 win over Baytown Sterling last week. The Eagles, they have number one offense in the district with over 425 yards a game. So we'll see. This will be a big, big matchup. Again, it's an 8-5A district matchup between Crosby and Barbers Hill. Big game over there. The Woodlands versus New Caney. The Woodlands comes in at 2-1, New Caney 3-0. This is a big game. You know, New Caney's averaging over 400 yards a contest on the ground. I mean, this is a big rushing offense as well. And the senior running back that they have, you got to see this guy before he hits the Saturdays. Saturday play. He's a Michigan State commit, Kedrick Rosano. He's the district's leading rusher. He's averaging well over 170 yards per game. So this is a guy that you might want to see. You're going to see him on Saturdays. You got maybe Mattel, who had a big game last week, is leading the way for the Highlanders on offense. But the defense is giving up a lot of yards. But this will be a big game. This may determine who wins the district or comes out on top over there in 13-6A. Tompkins coming off a tough one to Katy, 14-13 last week, with a matchup against a good Cinco Ranch team that's also coming in at 2-1. But I believe that Tompkins, you know, they're not gonna rest on that. They've been close to – they beat Katy a couple of years ago for that first loss in a district matchup in a long time, but we'll see how they continue to progress here. Senior quarterback and Stephen F. Foster commit Gavin Rutherford's averaging 281 yards per game. Definitely Tompkins has won three straight in this series, but it's going to be a big game over there in 19-6A. So Tompkins is I think, up for the challenge, but do not sleep on Seco Ranch. And we'll take a look at a couple more games before we get out of here. We appreciate you joining us on the Third Coast Gridiron. Ridge Point, Hightower is going to be a very, very intriguing matchup, 26A. Ridge Point's been playing a very tough schedule. They played against Austin Westlake and a strong Dickinson team. But, you know, Ridge Point is prepared for this. This is what they kind of do over there. And Hightower is a very good team as well. So we'll see who comes out on top on that one. That's a very, very intriguing game that you may want to check out. Here on the Third Coast Gridiron, we want to thank all our listeners, man. Check us out each week on the Lone Star Gridiron Network. You can follow us on Twitter at Third Gridiron, or follow me also on Twitter at MarkN44 or on the Mark Sports. Again, week four, we'll see who comes out on top. Some big games. We appreciate all the listeners, and we'll be back at you next week to talk about what happens this week here in the H-Town. This is the Third Coast Gridiron, H-Town's podcast.